In this video, I am going to explain four mastication muscles. What is mastication? Mastication is when you bite food. This is chewing. So these four muscles are very important for chewing food. Okay, so I'm going to explain two muscles first on this part. So what is this beige tape one? This beige tape represents temporaries. Temporaries is the biggest mastication muscle. It attaches on here, here, and a little bit more on posterior part here. So if anterior part contracts, it brings jaw up. This is mastication, chewing, right? By the way, this temporaries attaches on very deep to jaw. This place is coronoid process of mandible. Let's go to other side. Coronoid process is this one. Okay, so let's go back to this side. Temporaries attaches on lateral part and inserts on the coronoid process. If anterior parts contract, mastication happens. However, if this part, middle part or posterior part contract, it will bring jaw this way, right? Because muscle pulls this way, okay? So this brings the jaw posteriorly, brings this way. Make sense? Anterior part brings this way, mastication. The medial part, posterior part, brings jaw this way, posteriorly. So temporaries, simple enough. What are these red and yellow one? Actually, these two tapes represent one muscle. This is masseter. By the way, red one is superficial part of masseter. The yellow one is deep part of masseter. The superficial part originates from anterior part of zygomatic arch. I will look it later. The deep part originates on posterior part of zygomatic arch. Then they both insert on mandible. Okay? So where is zygomatic arch? This part, the deeper part originates from posterior part. The superficial part originates from anterior part. Let's go back to the other side. See, the superficial part, anterior. Deeper part, posterior. Okay? So the direction of fiber looks very perpendicular, right? Vertical. If masseter contracts, brings jaw up. This is mastication, right? However, the direction of fiber is not completely vertical. It's a little bit diagonal this way, right? So if masseter contracts this way, it will bring jaw slightly anterior this way. If masseter is completely perpendicular, it might act as a mastication only or chewing only. However, direction is a little bit diagonal. So if masseter contracts this way, it brings jaw slightly anterior. So temporaries, masseter, two muscles so far. Let's go to the other side. The other two muscles are gonna be very complicated. So this is from lateral view of jaw. You see this green tape and blue tape? These two muscles are very deep. Let's go to the inside view. Let's begin from the blue tape. This one. This is medial pterygoid muscle. Medial pterygoid. It attaches on the mandible, and this, the purple bone, this is sphenoid. Sphenoid. It attaches on mandible and sphenoid. The other one, other part, attaches on the maxilla, right here. So there are two parts on medial pterygoid, sphenoid and maxilla, and attaches on mandible. So direction of medial pterygoid is fairly perpendicular, fairly vertical. Imagine it's running this way. So, medial pterygoid is also mastication muscle. It may bring jaw slightly anterior, maybe just slightly, but major function is mastication, closing jaw. Okay, medial pterygoid. Simple enough, right? So if there is a medial pterygoid, there should be lateral pterygoid. That is this green one. This is very deep muscle. Do you notice there is split right here? So lateral pterygoid has two heads. On the superior part, originates from, actually this originates from sphenoid. It looks like it attaches on the maxilla, but it attaches on sphenoid. The lower part, this one also originates from sphenoid. I'm sorry if I made you confused. It looks like these two guys attach on maxilla. However, they are not. They attach on sphenoid. Please notify, origin is sphenoid. Make sense? Clarification? Okay. And these two guys insert on very close to temporal mandibular joint. The superior part inserts on the disc of articular capsule. To be simple, it's very close to temporal mandibular joint. And inferior part attaches on the mandible. So, medial pterygoid, lateral pterygoid. Since direction of lateral pterygoid is pretty much horizon, so basically when muscle contracts, it brings bone from insertion to origin. It moves towards origin. Remember, origin is this part, sphenoid. Okay, so it will move this way. So if lateral pterygoid contracts, it will bring jaw anteriorly. Okay? Anteriorly. Why? Because direction is pretty much horizon. This is origin, this is insertion, brings this way. Okay? So I explained four muscles today. Temporaries, masseter, remember there are two fibers, superficial, deep, and the very deep muscles. This is medial pterygoid, basically the mastication. And lateral pterygoid. It brings jaw anteriorly. So these four muscles, these guys are very important for chewing, of course, right? And these four muscles can be cause for temporal mandibular joint dysfunction. What is it? Temporal mandibular joint dysfunction? That's when you open up jaw, close jaw, it makes clicking noise here, or it's very hard to open close jaw. Temporal mandibular joint dysfunction. These four muscles can be cause for temporal mandibular joint dysfunction. I explained the other cause of TMJ in other video, which is a ligament. The ligament around this joint capsule can be cause for TMJ. However, these four muscles also can be cause for TMJ dysfunction. That's why these four muscles are very important for mastication and joint dysfunction right here. So I hope this video helps your understanding of jaw and mastication. If you liked today's video, please like, comment, and subscribe. See you in next video.